It is Friday night, February 3rd. We welcome you to HH Dow High School for girls basketball on MPS-TV as the Midland High Chemics make the short trip across town to take on the Dow High Chargers. Alongside Tom Bell, my name is Jason Harper. And Tom, tonight we've got girls basketball, a rematch from a game back in January that had a spectacular come-from-behind win for the Dow High Chargers, a heartbreaking loss for the Midland High Chemics. The rematch takes place tonight.
And these teams are very well matched. Dow, we are ranked in the state. Midland High currently right now is not. But they match up very, very well. You've got Dow wanting to avenge such a close win with a one that's a little more decisive tonight. And Midland wants to steal one on the Dow High court.
Yeah, the Dow High Chargers coming in 13-2 overall. Their only two losses on the season were to Saginaw Heritage. That was an overtime. Heritage currently ranked number one in their division, and they lost to Detroit Country Day in a tournament over the holidays, and Detroit Country Day is currently ranked number one in their division. Those are the only two losses that the Dow High Chargers have. They are 13-2, 8-1 in the Saginaw Valley under head coach Kyle Tyson. On the opposite side, the Midland High Chemics under coach Elaine Mahabier coming in with a 10-4 record. They are 7-3 in the Saginaw Valley. And the Midland High Chemics, you mentioned, you know, the losses, listen to this, all ranked teams the Midland High has lost to. They lost to Saginaw Heritage twice. They lost to Dow High in our last broadcast by 1 point. And they lost to Freeland in the very first game of the season, all ranked opponents. So this is a very strong Midland High team. We know the Dow High Chargers are extremely strong. We had a great matchup back in January, and we're anticipating another one here today.
Yeah, and that game went right down to the buzzer. Howard had a chance for a tip-in right at the end on the missed free throw by Alex Van Sumeren. That was a real nail-biter.
Both of these teams are coming off wins. The Midland High Chemics coming off a win against Saginaw Arthur Hill. That was a 46-33 victory on the road in Saginaw for Midland High. The Dow High Chargers coming off a huge win over Bay City Central, a game they won by 75-19. Five different Dow High players ended up in double digits against Bay City Central.
And that was a night that Kyle was able to kind of spread around some playing time and got some girls into the game that haven't seen a ton of playing time as of this date.
We are set to go. It is time for girls basketball on MPS-TV, the Chemics and the Chargers. And in just a couple of moments, we're going to turn things over to our public address announcer. Here's Jason Jahosky.
Tonight, your Chargers are hosting the Chemics of Midland High. Now for the starting lineups for starting number 10, Jordan Phillips. Senior number 14, Alex Van Sumer. Junior number 24, Hannah Smith. Senior number 33, Skylar Howard. And junior number 44, Maddie Berry. And the Chemics are coached by Ms. Elaine Mahavir. And now, the starting lineup for your Chargers. Senior number 10, Ellie Taylor. Senior number 12, Nadia Atten. Sophomore number 14, Molly Davis. Sophomore number 20, Maisie Taylor. Rounding out your Charger lineup, senior number 50, Kaylee Wasco.
The starting lineups, and we are set to go with girls basketball on MPS-TV. Jason Harper, Tom Bowen, a great crew of MCTV volunteers going old school for tonight's broadcast. A single camera for the Chemics and the Chargers. The Midland High Chemics in their visiting blue uniforms with gold numbers. The Dow High Chargers wearing the home white uniforms and green numbers for the Chargers. The starting five for Midland: Jordan Phillips, Alex Van Sumeren, Hannah Smith, Skylar Howard, and Maddie Berry. The starting five for the Chargers: Ellie Taylor, Nadia Atten, Molly Davis, Maisie Taylor, and Kaylee Wasco. And we are underway. The Chargers winning the tip-off. Molly Davis, sophomore guard, working the ball over to Maisie Taylor.
And the battle in the post has already started. We've got Howard and Wasco.
Wasco found herself in foul trouble early. How about the block from behind? And she went down hard. She went down immediately. The block was a beautiful block, but her knee, she went down incredibly tough, grabbing a hold of that left knee. And that is not what you want to see. Just 21 seconds into the game.
Yeah, very aggressive move coming in. Wasco thought she had an advantage to the basket. And Skylar Howard came from the far side to block the shot, but came down awkwardly. And it looks like it's her left knee that they're working on right now.
Earlier this season, Skylar Howard set a record for most rebounds for the Midland High Chemics, but Skylar Howard immediately howling out in pain as she blocked the shot from Kaylee Wasco, who got into foul trouble the last time that the Chemics and the Chargers met. And it was a great block, Tom, no doubt about that.
It absolutely was. There was no foul called.
It was as clean as blocks can get, but the training staff now working on the left knee of Skylar Howard. If you take a look at the crowd here at Dow High, this is not the start that either team wanted to take place, but the Midland High Chemics, not exactly a team that has a lot of depth.
No, when you suit up eight players, you're asking a lot of the three girls that are on the bench to fill roles. Now it's down to two.
We are just underway, 21 seconds into the game. No score between the Chemics and the Chargers, and an injury to Skylar Howard ended up bringing things to a screeching halt a whole lot earlier than what anybody wanted to. So the training staff is going to tend to Howard. Obviously, we hope that the injury is not as severe as it first appears. Ready to resume play in the Dow High Chargers going into Kaylee Wasco, but the Chemics stealing it away. Maddie Berry coming up with the steal for the Midland High Chemics. Working over to Jordan Phillips and now to Alex Van Sumeren. Van Sumeren leading the Midland High Chemics in three-pointers. She set a career record for Midland High earlier in the season, and a carry is going to be called on Jenny Grinwis, the junior that checked in and replaced Howard.
Well, one thing we can look for is that this is could be kind of a rallying point for the Chemics. When their star center is not into the game, you may find them doing some extra special things.
And you would expect the Chargers to do what they just did, and that is to go inside to Kaylee Wasco. Now it's a three-pointer that is off the mark, and the Chemics will come back the other direction. Midland High's got a two-on-one as they send it out to Van Sumeren. Three-pointer, hit it off the boards and count it, the first basket of the game. Alex Van Sumeren doing what she likes to do, and that is shoot the three-pointer.
She doesn't often bank one in, but that was pretty.
Maisie Taylor working over to her sister, Ellie. Ellie tries to go in, and they're going to call a foul. I believe Grenwith is going to pick up the foul that will send Ellie to the free throw line. Ellie Taylor is the senior. Maisie Taylor is the sophomore. Ellie is a candidate for Miss Basketball in the state of Michigan, and she's pretty good when it comes to the free throws.
She really is. She's great at the end of a game. Being a senior, she's had the experience. Very consistent.
Taylor hitting both of the free throws. Midland High leading 3-2, 6.5 minutes to go here in the first quarter. Chargers putting on a little bit of a press, but the Chemics able to beat it down court. Hannah Smith ended up traveling. A couple of unforced turnovers by the Chemics early on in this game.
Well, I know Midland likes to use Howard to help break the press, and Dow is trying to take advantage of Howard being out of the game.
Inside to Wasco, the size advantage with Howard not in, and now Ellie Taylor goes back to Wasco. We're going to have a travel down on the other end.
Well, not a very smooth beginning to this game, but these teams are really, it's punch and counterpunch right now.
Alex Van Sumeren with the basketball for the Chemics. Working on to the baseline, and a nice drive by Maddie Berry. Can't come up with anything. Maisie Taylor will come back the other way. Maisie looking to go coast to coast, and a foul is going to be called. Jordan Phillips is going to be called for the region. The first foul on Phillips, second one that goes against the Chemics. Chargers inbounding to Ellie Taylor. Works it over to Molly Davis. Davis, couple of dribbles, back to Ellie. Ellie goes back to Davis. Davis launching the three-pointer, count it. Molly Davis, three-pointer, giving the Chargers their first lead of the game. Dow High 5, Midland High 3, 5.5 minutes to go. That ball's deflected away, and it's going to stay Midland High basketball.
Well, as it stands right now, Midland's got to be real careful with their any foul troubles. Really going to be a hindrance, having only two on the bench.
Jordan Phillips over to Van Sumeren. Van Sumeren, one of only three seniors on the team for the Midland High Chemics. Driving inside is Maddie Berry. Berry can't get the shot to go. Ball's on the ground. Nobody's really sure where it is. They're going to end up calling a jump ball. So the possession arrow will be with Midland.
And you're right. A lot of them just didn't know that the ball was right at their shoelaces.
Chemics trying to find somebody to inbound to. Chargers not giving any real openings there. Hannah Smith working the ball back to Van Sumeren. Van Sumeren with a bounce pass to Jenny Grinwis. Now feeds it over to Jordan Phillips. Her shot is off the mark, and the Dow High Chargers will come away with the rebound. Ellie Taylor looking to take it from the outlet, and Taylor will get the bucket to fall. Ellie with a chance for a three-point play for Dow High.
Now that was a senior move. I've not seen that from Ellie, where she drives and then uses her left hand to bank it high off the glass.
The sophomore Sammy Van Sumeren is going to come into the game and will replace Jordan Phillips. Ellie Taylor next year has signed to play basketball at St. Louis University. She had a few offers on the table before deciding to sign with St. Louis, and Taylor completes the three-point play. Dow High 8, Midland High 3, 4:50 to go here in the first quarter. Sammy Van Sumeren's the sophomore. Alex is the senior, and Sammy trying to find somebody and ends up finding Maddie Berry. A junior able to get by Ellie Taylor. Spin move and then a block by Wasco. Kaylee Wasco coming away with the block. And originally they indicated it was Midland High basketball, but now the officials getting together and they are going to stick with, well, let's see what they're going to do.
I think Ellie and grabbing the ball was on the sideline.
Apparently it appears that they're going to stick with their original call. So actually they may have called a foul on that. Molly Davis may, well, either way, Midland High basketball.
Okay.
Not sure what they called there. Alex Van Sumeren dribbling over to Maddie Berry. Working back up over to Jenny Grinwis. Over to Alex Van Sumeren, three-pointer, no good. Battle for the rebound will be won by the Chargers. Maisie Taylor bringing it down. She outlets to her sister. Ellie takes a couple of dribbles, goes inside to Wasco. And Wasco able to score in the paint. First basket of the game for Kaylee Wasco. And the Chargers now leading by seven, and a foul called on Davis. Dow High 10, Midland High 3. 3:55 to go here in the first quarter.
And Midland's got a real tall order defensively because Wasco's got 5 inches on anybody that Midland High has in that post.
Alex Van Sumeren to Maddie Berry. Berry taking a couple of dribbles, had a big game against Arthur Hill, and a foul is going to be called on Davis. That's going to be the second one on Molly Davis, the sophomore guard coming off a double-digit scoring game against Bay City Central. And Midland High will go to the free throw line for the first time tonight.
With Davis being a sophomore, she will learn that she's got to fight through that screen much faster because she was late and reached and got Alex's arm.
Alex Van Sumeren. A little bit of college interest in Alex as well.
There is. She's going to Aquinas College over in the Grand Rapids area. They like her for her outside shot. She handles the ball well, and it's a school that requires you to be a pretty good student, and she is.
On the free throw line, she's able to hit two of the three free throws. Dow High 10, Midland High 5. 3.5 minutes to go here in the first quarter. Working inside and coming up with a steal and almost turning it over. The steal was nice by Hannah Smith. The pass afterwards almost led to a turnover.
Yeah, you got to continue the entire rebound and get the ball to your ball handler at that point. But we got Hannah Smith. Is now being guarded on the offensive side by Wasco. But as we're watching Midland High, they may have Berry on the inside, see if she can find an opening. And now Hannah has been scoring more and on the inside, but the ball is stolen.
Strong defense by the Chargers. They were double teaming and they outlet it over to Ellie Taylor, who finishes the play for the Chargers. And Elaine Mahabier is going to call a 30-second timeout with 2:44 to play here in the first quarter. It is Dow High 12, Midland High 5. And the Midland High Chemics, you know, after jumping on top of that three-pointer, now they need to kind of settle things down. The Chargers had great defense just a few moments ago.
Yeah, and they can allow Wasco to kind of move around underneath the basket because they don't have that Skylar Howard kind of skill underneath the basket. They've got other girls that can do some things, but Howard is the Midland High career rebounding leader, and they're going to miss that. They've got to get some girls to kind of pick up the slack. And I've noticed that Hannah Smith has been given the job of trying to stop Wasco.
Charger for the little bit of pressure after the timeout. Midland breaking free briefly, but then turning the ball over in the corner as Kaylee Wasco comes away with the steal. Ahead to Ellie Taylor. Ellie's already got 7 points on the night for the Dow High Chargers. Maisie goes back to Ellie, goes inside to Wasco, turns around and fires. Kelly Wasco taking advantage of being the tallest player on the floor, and now Dow High increases their lead. Chargers 14, Midland High 5, 2:10 to go here in the first quarter.
Midland might have to go zone to try to stop Wasco.
Maddie Berry with a nice drive to the basket, able to use the baseline. Berry able to get the bucket to fall through. First basket of the game for Berry. Dow High leading by a touchdown on a Super Bowl weekend.
Well done, well done.
14-7 in favor of Dow, 1:45 to go in the first quarter. Ellie Taylor taking advantage of the screen, works it over to Maisie Taylor, three-pointer off the mark, rebound, Kelly Wasco will get it, nobody around, and Wasco able to lay it off the board. 6 points in the game for Wasco. Dow High 16, Midland High 7, 1:25 to play in the quarter. Maddie Berry works it to Hannah Smith, over to Alex Van Sumeren from the corner. Van Sumeren's shot is no good. Rebound was briefly held by Grennis, but then it was taken away by Maisie Taylor, who ended up traveling. Did she step up with the ball?
She may have dragged the foot trying to evade Van Sumeren. I didn't see it from here, but you don't look at a possession in the first quarter as being an important one, but right now Midland really has to try to stay as close to Dow as possible.
Couple of new players into the game. Asia Blanton, the senior, coming into the game for Dow High, and Hope Odell, a junior, is into the game for Midland. And we got an offensive foul call. Hope Odell comes in, and maybe a little moving screen?
That's exactly what it was. She needed to stay absolutely upright, and I'm sure she tried to lean in to be as much of an obstacle as she could be.
Under a minute to go here in the first quarter of the contest. Ellie Taylor working the basketball for the Dow High Chargers. Three-pointer by Ellie is no good. Rebound pulled down by Hannah Smith. Hannah's going to outlet it over to Maddie Berry. Three-pointer from the top. That is no good. Odell will get the rebound. Sammy Van Sumeren, she can't get the shot to go. Kaylee Wasco will get the rebound for the Chargers. Couple of scoring chances for Midland, but they end up empty-handed. Working inside, Asia Blanton, her first shot of the night. No good. Midland will come back. 15 seconds to go in the quarter. Midland High will play for the final shot. Clock down to 7, 6, 5. Sammy Van Sumeren with the basketball. Clock reading 3-2. Alex fires a three-pointer. It'll count if it goes, but it does not. And the first quarter ends up coming to an end here at Dow High with the Chargers leading the Chemics by a score of 16-7. The game here tonight being produced by MCTV Volunteers. If you'd like to become an MCTV Volunteer, there will be orientations taking place nearly every month in the spring, February 11th, March 11th, and also in May. Lots of opportunities to become involved here at MCTV. For more information, you can pick up the phone, call 837-3474. You can also find us on Facebook and become an MCTV Volunteer. The cost is just $45, and that also includes your first year as an access user fee. The story here, Tom, if you're just tuning in, is the fact that Midland High Skylar Howard going down early in the game with an injury, and the size mismatch now is a huge advantage for the Chargers.
It really is, and Wasco is a skilled post player. I mean, she has gotten better every year, and that's why Binghamton University in New York State is really high on her. She's got moves to the right, to the left. She really closes off her defender well underneath the basket. She's had a couple of blocks already. She's a handful for Midland High right now.
Some first quarter stats. Jeff Yoder providing stats for us here tonight. Ellie Taylor, the leading scorer with 7 points, but it is Kaylee Wasco, 6 points, 4 rebounds, and 1 block. And that is in the first 8 minutes of the game for Midland High. Alex Van Sumeren is the leading scorer. She has 5 of Midland High's 7 points. Working inside, the Chargers with the basketball here in the second quarter. Ellie Taylor can't get the shot to go. Gets her own rebound, but the putback is going to be blocked by Midland High. Alex Van Sumeren will come away with the block.
And I really can't see how she wasn't fouled in there. That was pretty crowded, but the officials let him play on.
9-point lead for the Chargers early here in the second quarter. Spin move by Maddie Berry does not get the friendly bounce, and the rebound is pulled down by Nadia Atten, the senior who was relatively quiet, but Nadia is one of those role players for the Chargers. May not end up with the headline, but she definitely puts in the minutes and does a great job out there.
She's a great natural athlete. She can run, she can jump, she's got good size, great teammate. And she starts for them, but plays a number of different roles.
Chargers slowing the pace down a little bit. They got Paige Messick into the game, and Messick on the get and go, but did not go up for the shot. Instead, Maisie Taylor will work the basketball over to Nadia Atten, and the shot taken by Atten is no good. Maddie Berry will get the rebound for Midland. Kind of a interesting group on the floor for the Chargers right now.
Yeah, they've given up some of their inside scoring. They've got a couple of extra guards. I think that Kyle might be experimenting with something for a little bit.
Kaylee Wasco not in the game, so they're going, as you mentioned, a little more guard play than underneath. Into the paint, Maddie Berry, count the bucket.
Well, right now, as far as inside play, Berry may be the most accomplished inside scorer on the court right now. You know, you've got Ellie Taylor can score from just about anywhere, but...
She almost scored being pushed to the outside. Good defense that time by Midland High. It's the Chargers 16, the Chemics 9, 5:35 to go here in the second quarter. Long three-pointer by Berry. No good, and rebound by Nadia Atten. Chargers playing a slower pace here in the second quarter than what we saw in the first quarter.
They have not scored yet.
Paige Messick, she's a sophomore. Now they go inside to Asia Blatton, and Blatton with a nice move backing up Odell and just kept driving towards the basket little by little, and Asia Blatton gets her first basket of the game and the first basket of the quarter for Dow High. Chargers 18, Midland High 9, for just under 5 minutes to go.
That was a nice drop step by Blanton.
Sammy Van Sumeren picked up her dribble, able to find somebody. They find Alex Van Sumeren open for a three-pointer, but the shot was no good. Couple of subs. Kaylee Wasco will come back into the game after taking a couple of minute break, and Jenny Grinwis will check back into the game for Midland.
Well, size-wise, it looks like Hannah Smith at about 5'10 and a half has drawn Kaylee Wasco as the being her defender.
Wasco tried to feed it to Ellie Taylor, but the Chemics will come away with the ball and then stolen away by Ellie. Nice job defensively. And Ellie Taylor able to put the bucket in for Midland. The biggest lead of the game for the Chargers. Dow 20, Midland 9, 4:10 to go in the second quarter.
Yeah, you got to really watch that outlet. You can't be sloppy with that. We got Berry kicking it out. Hannah Smith, a little bit long. And Midland High struggling a little bit with their outside shot tonight. But Dow is going to look at Wasco and see what happens. That's tough. That's tough to defend.
Elaine Mahabier will call a timeout. Kaylee Wasco adding another bucket inside. And with Skylar Howard injured, it is Kaylee Wasco dominating inside the paint. And with 3:50 to go here in the second quarter, it is Dow High 22, Midland High 9. As you look at Kyle Tyson and the Dow High Chargers, as right now they've got things going their way.
Yeah, and I'm sure he's telling them that they continue to prepare for the tournaments. They are a well-balanced team. They don't want to get into any bad habits. They've got to continue to attack the basket. And they started to get kind of relaxed on offense. They weren't really finding open shots. When Wasco got in there, it gave them a little more focus on the one thing to do is to get it to Wasco in underneath and then let her either go to the basket or kick it out to one of their accomplished shooters.
Now the Dow High Chargers, as we mentioned in our beginning of the game, only two losses on the season. One of those losses was here at Dow in overtime to Saginaw Heritage, and they still have one more meeting during the regular season with Heritage, and then most likely that is going to be the first game for Dow High in the postseason, which will be at Saginaw Heritage. Dow High drawing a first round bye. They will play the winner of Saginaw Heritage and Mount Pleasant, and Heritage more than likely going to pick up that victory, although you never know. That's why we play the games.
Sure.
Midland High also with a first-round bye as Kaylee Wasco comes up with the block. Chemics will play either Bay City Central or Bay City Western in the opening round of the postseason. But that is about a month away. Right now they're concentrating on tonight's game. And right now it is Molly Davis who fires a three-pointer, the sophomore, back into the game for the Chargers. And it is all Dow High here in the second quarter. Dow 25, Midland 9. 3 minutes to go in the half.
Yeah, Midland, their defense went way over to the left-hand side and left Molly wide open.
Sammy Van Sumeren drives in and a foul. Actually, no, it's going to, the ball ended up hitting the above the basket. So that is what the whistle was.
Well, we really didn't expect this, but I'm sure Midland didn't expect to have such an uphill climb with less than a full roster.
Yes. If you're just tuning in, 21 seconds into the game, Skylar Howard went down with what appears to be a left knee injury. And now we've got a travel call that is going to be called against Molly Davis. So the Chemics, when that happens, Tom, as a coach, you're basically throwing your game plan out of the window, and now you're coaching on the fly until you can get into the locker room.
Yeah, and everything you've worked on in practice is really, you've got to change everything, especially when Howard does so much for them. She brings the ball up against the press because she's usually can overmatch the girl that's guarding her with her ball handling.
Ellie Taylor with the ball for the Chargers. Taylor working back out over to Paige Messick. Messick goes inside to Kaylee Wasco, and Wasco with that nice hook into the paint. And again, you hate to keep bringing up the point, but without the size of Howard, Kaylee Wasco is having a field day. Wasco is 6'2", and she's having a good time in the paint so far tonight. Three-pointer, and Ellie Taylor got a little bit of skin. I'm not sure she thought so, but the official thought so. And that's going to bring up three free throws for Alex Van Sumeren.
Well, when you quickly grab into the shot, and the shot went way off to the left, and the official is near there. Sometimes you can hear those things, too.
Van Sumeren unable to get the first free throw to go. Second one does go through. Chargers are going to bring Asia Blanton and Maisie Taylor back into the game. Molly Davis will head to the bench. Alex Van Sumeren had three free throw shots earlier in the game. Now she's back on the line for three free throws. Makes two of the three. She's 4 of 6 on the night from the free throw line. Dow High 27, Midland High 11, 1:35 to go here in the second quarter. Chargers have done everything they wanted to do here in the first half of this game. Kaylee Wasco traveled. That's not what they wanted to do.
Well, Midland High double-teamed Wasco that time, and I think that was probably a pretty good idea. She kind of felt a little rushed because she really had no left or right to go, and she shuffled her feet.
Alex Van Sumeren to Sammy Van Sumeren. Back to Alex. Alex takes a couple of dribbles. Now working over to Maddie Berry. Berry thought about driving in. Instead, dishes it back out to Alex. A minute to go here in the second quarter. Maddie Berry with the ball for Midland. Chargers playing nice defense, and we've got a whistle and a stoppage. And we have a stoppage because the Dow High student section was using the flashlight on their phone to try to blind the Midland High Chemics. That is uncalled for, and I'm glad the official stopped play. Now we're back to action.
I don't know. Do it again. It's a technical.
I don't know that you can call a technical against a student section. Chargers coming up with a steal. Ellie Taylor, three-pointer. You could clear out the student section. It'd be an awful quiet game.
Yeah.
Midland High back with the ball. Maddie Berry, three-pointer. No good. Macy Taylor will come away with the basketball. 20 seconds to go in the second quarter. Ellie Taylor, three-pointer in and out. Good rebound by the Chargers. And going to the free throw line will be Nadia Atten. Good job by Atten of blocking out and coming away, able to get that rebound.
Well, the Chargers really have not shot that well this first half. They've missed a lot of fairly high percentage shots inside, where this game really could be long gone. We're looking at 28-11 currently. But Dow, I think in my mind, has missed about five high percentage shots already.
Nadia missing the free throw. Quinn McCaffrey, by the way, has checked in for the Chargers. She's a junior that has really taken Kyle Tyson by surprise. She has done a tremendous job coming off the bench. Final seconds, and from the baseline, Maddie Berry getting the bucket to go for Midland High. And the second quarter comes to an end. A half of basketball controlled by the Dow High Chargers, who take advantage of an unfortunate situation early on in the game, and Dow High able to use the paint to their advantage. Couple of three-pointers as well, and the Chargers building a lead 28-13 here at halftime. The Charger Pep Band will take us to break. You are watching high school basketball on MPS-TV at halftime. Dow High 28, Midland High 13. We'll be back with the third quarter. We are back here at Dow High School. If you take a look at the fans in the stands for girls basketball here on MPS-TV, Jason Harper alongside Tom Bell, our staff man Jeff Yoder, and a great crew of MCTV volunteers, John Walters working the audio, Jim Malik and Dennis Caney working the camera for us here tonight as we bring you coverage of the Chemics and the Chargers. A busy winter here on MPS-TV. We had hockey, we've got swimming coming up, and now we've got girls basketball and boys basketball this weekend as well. Some halftime stats as the Dow High Chargers come away in the first half, leading Midland High 28-13. Ellie Taylor with 9 points, but the leading scorer for the Dow High Chargers is Kaylee Wasco. 10 points, 4 rebounds, and 2 blocks. She is definitely on her way to a double-double here tonight. 13 rebounds in all for the Dow High Chargers. Midland High being led by Alex Van Sumeren. 7 points for Alex, and Maddie Berry right behind her with 6 points. Those are the only two players that have scored for the Midland High Chemics. Van Sumeren and Berry, 8 rebounds for the Midland High Chemics. So, Tom, halftime adjustments. Obviously, the Dow High Chargers, things kind of doing what they want to do. For Midland High, if you're Elaine Mahabier, you finally got a chance to address everything and talk about what you're going to do and the changes you're going to make with the injury to Skylar Howard.
You got to pull off some magic. You've got to defend as a team the post and try to make sure you're challenging their comfort on the arc, because Dow's got some three-point shooters, and with Wasco on the inside, they've got to give Grinwis and Hannah Smith some help in there. but they can't allow Taylor to get comfortable hitting those threes because it's an uphill climb, definitely.
Well, the Midland High Chemics were bit with the injury bug before the season started with Sadie DeWelt going down and Jalen Williams both going down with injuries. Williams no longer a part of the team. Sadie DeWelt not expected to play this season because of injury. Now you've got Skylar Howard injured. So injuries, those are three of your anticipated five starters that are now starting. And again, we don't know the severity of the injury to Skylar Howard. We know that she had ice on her knee, but we do not know. So she might be back, you know, for the Midland High Chemics. Let's hope that she's going to come back sooner than later.
At this point, you have to hope that she's going to be a healthy player again before this season is over with.
We had a stoppage of play, not sure what for, but the officials talking to the scorer's table, and apparently everything is satisfied. So here we go. Continuing play just underway in the third quarter. Midland High going left to right, but Maddie Berry traveled.
Yeah, I think Maddie might be feeling like she's got to do a little bit more than what she's been comfortable doing and trying to take up some of the slack.
There's been a lot of on-force turnovers on both teams here tonight.
Yeah, there's been a lot of traveling for teams that have both have seen a lot of success this year.
Thought about the three, did Molly Davis. Instead, she works it back out to Nadia. Now to Ellie Taylor. Ellie splitting apart the Chemic defense, and Ellie Taylor continuing to have her strong game. And Macy Taylor came away with a steal. She was able to knock the ball off of Berry. So credit. Actually, was that Molly Davis? Or was that Macy Taylor that had the hustle?
That was Molly.
Davis. It was Davis that had the
Molly
hustle.
Molly Davis.
Molly Davis doing the hustling for the Dow High Chargers, and Chargers leading 30-13. I don't think anybody after the matchup in January anticipated this to be the score early in the third quarter here tonight. Coming away with a steal, Midland High's Jordan Phillips knocks the ball away. Midland High across midcourt, working over to Maddie Berry, three-pointer in and out, rebound pulled down by Nadia Atten.
The shots just aren't dropping for the Chemics.
Beautiful pass, but Molly Davis can't get the bucket to go. Midland High tried to go coast to coast, and a foul is going to be called. Hannah Smith, the junior, will go to the free throw line.
That may have been on Atten.
It was only the first one. Nobody really in foul trouble. In fact, neither team made it to the bonus, and they're actually going to call that on the floor, so nobody will go to the free throw line. Midland will inbound the ball. Alex Van Sumeren, bounce pass inside to Hannah Smith, and Smith was fouled. She will go to the free throw line this time.
Well, Midland is going to have to force the issue. They're going to have to get to the line. They're going to have to hit some shots. They've got to kind of eat into this 17-point deficit.
Now, we mentioned nobody in foul trouble. That has changed because Molly Davis, the sophomore for the Chargers, now has three fouls. But she is still in the game. Meanwhile, Hannah Smith on the free throw line for the Chemics, coming off a 13-point game against Arthur Hill, but she missed both of the free throws. And Maddie Berry tried to save the ball out of bounds but could not do it.
Well, the gym just seems really quiet in a game with this rivalry. These fans just aren't an active part of this.
Offensive foul is going to be called against Wasco. They're going to say that she pushed her way to get free. I'm not sure that she agrees with the call, but that is what the official said. Kyle Tyson is going to get a little explanation as the official moves down.
It all happened right in front of him, and I guess he was looking the other way.
Kyle Tyson has got to be happy with what has happened here tonight in the terms of the scoring, because the Chargers are playing a great game against the crosstown rivals, and some big games still on the schedule. Dow High still hoping to get a share of the Saginaw Valley title, or possibly if somebody can upset Heritage. You know, Dow still wants that Saginaw Valley League Championship. Counts the bucket for Midland High's Hannah Smith, the junior. Able to get on the board. Nadia Atten wide open on the other end. Answering the call, Atten was all by herself.
And Midland just has to get back. After they make the basket, they got to hustle back. Atten got behind the defense.
Dow High 32, Midland High 15, 5 minutes to go in the third quarter. Maddie Berry long, or Alex Van, no, that was Berry that shot the three-pointer.
That was Berry.
Three-pointer, no good. Dow High coming back with Ellie Taylor. DeMasi, wide open, count it.
Chargers.
You can't leave anybody with the last name of Taylor wide open with the basketball because they're going to shoot it.
Well, Kyle talks about Maisie being a distributor, sees the court, and that's what her role is. But leave her alone, that's what she's going to do. She'll knock down the three.
Doesn't matter, older sister, younger sister, brother, mom, dad. If you give a Taylor a basketball, she's going to shoot. They're going to shoot a three-pointer. Like that, Ellie Taylor, Cowboy three-pointer. And the Dow High Chargers are rolling here at home. Elaine Mahabier is going to call a timeout.
So what you're saying is that this run is tailor-made.
Exactly. 4:14 to go here in the third quarter. It is Dow High 38, Midland High 15. As you take a look at Elaine Mahabier and the Midland High Chemics trying to come up with some kind of answer against a team that is ranked high in the state and the Dow High Chargers.
Well, and Midland High's got some good players, but they rely on Skylar Howard a lot. I mean, she does a lot of the things that the players Midland High has are not capable of doing or haven't been doing throughout the season. But there's still a lot of talent here on Midland High's team.
And we've got a foul called before Midland can inbound the ball. Ellie Taylor, by the way, 14 points in the contest, five of them here in the third quarter. Long outlet pass. Maddie Berry able to take control of it. Goes inside to Hannah Smith. And Smith will get the bucket and the foul on a chance for a three-point play.
Now that was a move to the basket for Hannah that I have not seen her do yet. And I've seen in the, you know, as I watched the results in the paper that she is scoring a lot more. She just seemed very, very comfortable with that drop step and putting the ball on the glass. And I think I'm now seeing why she's been in double figures a number of times in previous games.
Hannah Smith able to complete the three-point play. It's still all Dow. It is a 20-point game, 38-18. 4 minutes to go here in the third quarter. Quinn McCaffrey is back into the game for the Chargers, and a three-second call is going to be called against Dow High.
Yeah, at that point, Kaylee Wasco was setting up on the block with her foot in the lane, and they just miscommunicated on what was going to happen.
Now, we mentioned briefly earlier, Tom, but Quinn McCaffrey, she's a junior, but she's one of those players that has really improved week to week, day to day. Kyle Tyson really likes how she is coming off the bench.
Yeah, I had a chance to talk to Kyle before the game. And I asked him, who's the biggest surprise for you? And he says it's the improvement of Quinn McCaffrey, that she's been able to do a lot of things, give a lot of energy and effort to a team that's already very skilled.
That time, Maisie Taylor and Kaylee Wasco were not on the same page. Not very often that transpires, but it just did. Dow High with a big lead here against the Midland High Chemics. And Molly, and there's the turnover. Molly Davis looking to go coast to coast, but she can't complete the bucket. Rebound by Ellie Taylor, and the putback will send Ellie to the free throw line.
Now, one of the things that I know Kyle is going to have to try to battle with his team is to stay focused in this game. That they've got a comfortable lead right now. They don't want to get lackadaisical. They want to stay in control.
That foul, by the way, on Sammy Van Sumeren, which is only her first. In fact, that was the first foul of the second half for Midland. Ellie Taylor continues to be perfect on the free throw line. A Miss Basketball candidate, and she's putting in some good numbers here tonight to help her cause. Dow High leading by 22 points with under 3 minutes to go here in the third quarter. Shot taken by Hannah Smith is no good. Chargers will come back the other direction. Knocked away, recovered. Macy Taylor tried to outlet it, still on the ground, but it's going to be Dow High basketball.
Yeah, there are times both teams look really sharp, and other times they just have a hard time connecting. And I know the coaches are frustrated with that kind of flow at this time of the season.
Only one senior on the floor for Midland High. There's a carry called on Molly Davis. The other two seniors on the team are currently out with an injury. And again, we do not have any kind of an update on Skylar Howard. We know that it's a knee injury that happened early in the game, but we won't speculate any more than that. But we do not expect her to return tonight, and hopefully the prognosis is good for the rest of the season. Nice steal there by the Midland High Chemists, and Alex Van Sumeren will get the bucket. And then a foul called. The foul was after the bucket, so Van Sumeren's basket is good. But then the Midland High Chemics committed a foul, so.
And that was Hannah Smith, I believe.
Which is the second one on Smith. 2:23 to play in the third quarter. Dow High 40, Midland High 20. Glad you are with us as we continue our winter sports coverage on MPS-TV. Maisie Taylor worked into older sister. Now Asia Blanton, who just checked back into the game. Back to Ellie. Ellie pulls up her dribble. She's bailed out by Paige Messick, another sophomore that has checked back into the game. Ellie Taylor working over to Maisie. Midland playing nice defense, which you like to see in a game that is a 20-point deficit, still playing hard, and a foul will be called, and Ellie Taylor, she just does not stop. And Ellie able to get the bucket and the foul and a chance for a three-point play.
Well, you know that she has made that shot before, where she's got enough roll, climbs the rim, and goes in. You know, she's played a lot of basketball. But, yeah, you got to give Midland some credit here. They're playing their hearts out. It's just that they're missing an important cog in what has made their success.
Well, and the Dow High Chargers are playing great basketball as
yes,
well.
They are.
They
are.
Don't discredit what Dow High has done. They're playing their game plan. And Kyle Tyson actually taking that timeout a few moments ago. Tonight's game, also a benefit game. You see a lot of those shirts in the stands of the Coaches versus Cancer shirts that were sold at the door and at both of the schools. A lot of support going on to help fight cancer. And Tom, I don't know anybody that doesn't know somebody that has either been affected or knows somebody affected by cancer. And tonight, both schools are raising money to try to find a cure for cancer. Well, the update on the stats on Ellie Taylor, 18 points and 4 rebounds. That's a pretty good game.
Yep.
And we're only, we still have 9 minutes and 47 seconds of basketball to be played tonight.
But I wouldn't doubt that Kyle is going to start really running girls in and out here as this game progresses, because this is an opportunity for some girls to play in front of a sizable crowd.
The free throw, as expected, is good by Ellie Taylor. Dow High 43, Midland High 20, 1:40 to go here in the third quarter. Maddie Berry working the ball for Midland. Now Alex Van Sumeren will feed it back out, trying to work the baseline, and a nice give there, but Hannah Smith could not get the shot to go. Jenny Grinwis had a great pass, but unable to come away with anything, and the Chargers will set up their offense.
Yeah, when Grinwis drove to the basket, she drew a crowd and gave an opportunity for an inside pass that just didn't drop.
Gwen McCaffrey, she's in the book. We talked about her earlier, and the junior able to get the bucket for Dow High, increasing the lead, and Paige Messick nearly came up with a steal. I love the fact that so many players for Dow High, we talk about the starters as they jump all as strong. We talk about, you know, all the talent they have, but we've seen player after player come off the bench for the Dow High Chargers and not miss a beat tonight.
Yeah, well, you know, you've got kids that have practiced with these talented starters the entire year. Gets everybody better. You know, that's a nice thing about having a full roster of very accomplished players.
There are eight players, and what a drive. Count the bucket, Molly Davis. There are eight players on this Dow High roster, and any of the eight could start and play for any team in the area. This is a talented team.
Yes. Yeah.
Lane violation called against the Chargers. So,
and from what I've heard, that Dow High girls will scrimmage. There's a group of boys that come in, and they play against the boys in practice. And it really helps them. The boys have been really good about kind of modeling the skill of the team that's coming in.
Into the paint, Maddie Berry able to get a bucket to stop the Midland High scoring drought. 20 seconds to go here in the third quarter. Dow High 47, Midland High 22. Molly Davis goes inside Ellie Taylor to Asia Blanton. Paige Messick now will work it back out to take Ellie. Ellie goes inside Blanton, who got too far underneath the basket. Can't do anything with it. And the outlet for Midland High, the third quarter, will come to an end. But the Chargers, the train just keeps on a rolling here at home. Three quarters in the book, and the Dow High Chargers leading the Midland High Chemics by a score of 47 to 22. And if we take a look at Kyle Tyson and the Dow High Chargers, Tom, I want to talk about another thing this Dow High Charger team does that is kind of unique, but Kyle Tyson believes it's very beneficial, and that's the fact that Wednesdays have become yoga night for the Chargers.
Yeah, I was talking to him about that. He said that it's a great way, middle of the week, take a breather, step away from basketball, and the girls love it. And they go to a class here in Midland, and it's for stretching, it's for strength. But they don't take a basketball with them. And I think that keeps you a little more fresh than some of the teams that just drill basketball every single day of the week, practically.
I absolutely love the benefit of yoga. I think that is a great idea. Whoever came up with the idea, implemented by Kyle Dyson, I think that is definitely very beneficial for this Dow High Charger team. Not only the benefits of doing yoga, but the fact that it gives the mind and the body a chance to take a break from basketball.
And the idea came from Jeff Jaster, the principal at Midland High. His wife taught here at Dow High, and she made this suggestion that he might want to try that, and it's worked out to their benefit.
Some updated stats from our stat man, Jeff Yoder. Ellie Taylor, 19 points, 4 rebounds. Kaylee Wasco, 10 points, 5 rebounds, and 2 blocks. Wasco did not play very much in the third quarter. However, a couple of Chargers are in foul trouble. Nadia Atten and Molly Davis both have 3 fouls. For Midland High, Alex Van Sumeren, 9 points. Maddie Berry, 8 points. But the Midland High Chemics only scored 7 points total in the third quarter. And when you're down 20-plus points, that's not a... Yeah, math was not my best subject, Tom, but that's not a good calculation.
Well, you like to try to make a statement coming out of the halftime talk, and Dow made the statement.
Midland High will go to the free throw line, but Hannah Smith is limping a little bit. Chemics cannot afford any more injuries.
Hannah's a tough kid, and she's being asked to play a little bit out of position. She hasn't been a post player, but right now she's kind of dabbling in that because of the absence of Howard. She does pretty well.
Her right ankle or right heel. Midland High becoming a mash unit quickly. On the free throw line, Hannah Smith able to get the bucket to fall.
And we've got Molly Davis bringing the ball up the court. Molly's in a little bit of foul trouble. She's got to kind of watch that she doesn't get too aggressive going to the basket. And Dow High is trying to set up Wasco on the block. Shot by Davis is off, and the rebound goes to Berry.
I don't know who I can blame for this cold, but I want to blame somebody. And there's a block as Molly Davis comes up with the block, and she is all by herself down on the other end. Complete the play. Get the block, get the bucket, Molly Davis.
Molly's got really good hands to catch the ball and then put the soft touch up on the glass. We saw her do that a number of times in the game at Midland High.
All Dow High. There's a shot taken by Midland High's Jenny Grinwith. It's no good. 6:35 to go here in the fourth quarter. Dow High 49, Midland High 23. And Nadia Etten is going to pick up her fourth foul as she tried. Oh, is that the fifth one? I'd like to find out it is the fifth one. So Nadia Etten has fouled out for the Dow High Chargers. As Asia Blanton comes back in, Hope Odell also re-entering the game as Midland High will go to the free throw line. Maddie Berry will shoot 1-1 for the Chemics.
Well, Dow doesn't lose much bringing in Asia Blanton. They're just different kinds of players. Asia is really good and strong underneath the basket. Good rebounder, too.
She pulls one down there. The last time these two teams played, it went down to the final tenths of a second to decide who came away with the victory. Tonight, that is not the case. It has been all Chargers as Molly Davis has called for a carry. Allie Taylor had a very short break, but she is back into the game.
Well, one of the criticisms about playing AAU ball is that they do let the palming go. And I know Molly has played a lot of extra basketball in her lifetime. And every so often, she gets caught on that.
Anna Smith working over to Jordan Phillips. Back to Alex Van Sumeren. Kimmicks actually scored the first basket of the game, but that was the only time that Midland had an advantage tonight. Long three-pointer, count it. Alex Van Sumeren, only her second three-pointer of the night.
But she may have 10. 10, okay.
She is in double digits with 5.5 minutes to play. Dow High 49, Midland High 26. Working inside of Wasco, bounce pass to Blanton, works it back over to Maisie Taylor, counts the three. Unbelievable performance we are witnessing tonight for the Dow High Chargers. They had a huge win their last game against Bay City Central, and they're on their way to a huge win here tonight, and Midland High turns over the ball on a travel.
Well, the thing that's impressive about Maisie Taylor is that when you scout Dow, you kind of have it figured out what role she's playing, and she basically sets up her teammates. Then all of a sudden, you kind of back off, and she kills you with that shot.
They're good. This Charger team is putting on a show here tonight. Asha Blanton all by herself. She got in front of her defender, Odell. Blanton able to put the bucket up. Elaine Mahabier is going to call another timeout with 4:46 to play here tonight. Dow High 54, Midland High 26.
Yeah, and I think that we're getting almost to the point where people will see this score in the paper and they'll wonder what happened. You know, and there is a story behind it. But the girls have not given up at all. Dow's playing exceptionally well right now, and Midland's just a little shorthanded. But I'm encouraged with what Hannah Smith has been doing and also Alex Van Sumeren. Both of them are really getting some high percentage shots. And Barry's had some good looks. It's just everything's been off the bracket for a good portion of the game. And I think she's kind of pressing it a little bit. You know, I think throughout the year, she's either been the number one scorer or number two. And when Howard is no longer a factor of this game, at least, I think Barry has really felt like an awful lot has landed on her shoulders. So if she sits back and relaxes, I think things will be a little better.
If you are watching this game on Charter Communications or AT&T UVerse, we also will let you know that you can tune in on the MPS YouTube channel and watch the broadcast of the game in high-definition video. That's on the MPS YouTube channel. We know you got a new smart TV, so you can figure out how to use it and stream high school sports from MPS.
Bothers me when my TV has a higher IQ than I do.
Working into the paint, Hannah Smith will get the bucket.
Nice move inside by Hannah.
4:15 to play. Dow High 54, Midland High 28. Hockey this weekend, boys basketball, girls basketball, swimming coming up as well. And a steal, almost a steal, by Alex Van Sumeren, but the ball ends up being knocked out, and so the Chargers will have the basketball.
Midland continues to battle.
We're going to have a push-off called on Kaylee Wasco. She was open, but that's because a pass interference call.
On a Super Bowl weekend, another reference.
I don't want to be the bearer of bad news, but Hannah Smith is not 100%. She headed to the bench a few moments ago, limping slightly. It's just been a war out there for the Chemics, and a three-pointer there by Maddie Berry.
There we go. That's the shot that the Chemic fans are used to seeing from her.
3:35 on the clock. Dow High 54, Midland High 31. Ellie Taylor lost the dribble but able to recover. Kaylee Wasco from the corner, count it. Wasco's been relatively quiet tonight. In fact, that's her first basket of the second half.
She's tough. She's got the inside game and that little jumper. 15-foot jumper. She's a handful inside.
Inside Hope Odell, and Kaylee Wasco comes up with the block. That's her third block, I believe. Inside to Wasco. Trying to take advantage of the height advantage, but can't do it. Midland High will come back the other direction. Looking into the corner, now back around. Inside to Odell, back out to Berry. Into the paint, Maddie Berry can't get the bounce to fall through.
Now Berry can take advantage of the fact she's left-handed. It gives her a little quicker step on the defense.
Kaylee Wasco, she lets that shot from the corner. Roscoe's going to be going to New York to play basketball next year. 6'3". Maybe on her way to a double-double tonight, depending on how many rebounds she can get.
The program says she's 6'2", but Kyle tells me closer to 6'3".
Ellie Taylor, three-pointer. Baseline shot by Ellie. She makes it look easy. 2 minutes to play. It is a 30-point lead for the Dow High Chargers. From the free throw line, the shot from Van Sumeren doesn't go. Kaylee Wasco with the rebound.
Well, at this point, you would expect Dow to empty their bench, but they don't have enough players on their bench to empty it, so we see their stars out here.
Well, there's only eight players on the Dow High Charger bench. All eight players have played tonight.
Yeah, they played a ton.
And you've got, you know, if you are somebody that's wondering, hey, why are we seeing the starters on the floor? Well, Nadia Atten has fouled out. That puts you down to seven. So you're going to have at least three of them on the floor no matter what you do. Baseline, Maddie Berry can't get it to go. Odell's putback is no good. 90 seconds to play. Ellie Taylor, no good. Rebound ripped away. Ellie Taylor. It doesn't matter what the score is. Ellie is going to play hard, and yeah, you can't say anything negative about that. You're going to play, and Ellie Taylor is one of those individuals that's going to play the entire game.
Well, she never gives up a play. I mean, she's always looking for that opportunity for an extra shot.
Like that. Allie Taylor, three-pointer. Just over a minute to play. Dow High 64, Midland High 31. And I don't think there is a single person in the gym that won the pool predicting this as a final score.
Oh, absolutely not. I mean, this game would be a lot closer with both teams full speed.
Molly Davis, the shot no good. Midland High will come away with the ball. Final minute of play. We're down to 40 seconds to go. Alex Van Sumeren dribbling the ball for Midland High. I think Midland, well, there's a three-pointer by Van Sumeren. No good. Molly Davis will get the rebound, and a foul will be called. For somebody that doesn't have a whole lot of size, Molly Davis is listed as 5'7". Davis pulls down a lot of rebounds for a sophomore.
Sometimes it's just a matter of being active with your hands, getting the tip, and then bringing it into your space. And she does that very well. That was a punt.
Yeah. They're going to call Jenny Grinwitz on the foul. 17 seconds to go. Dow High is going to continue to try to put the points on the board, and this will end up sending Paige Messick to the free throw line. She is a sophomore for the Dow High Chargers. We mentioned, you know, the role players for Dow High, so many weapons, and there's another one playing hard right down to the wire is Messick.
And she's got two more years here. You know, she looks like she may be the heir apparent to maybe being the point guard for next year.
She hits one of two free throws. Hope Odell able to get the rebound. Final seconds ticking off the clock here at Dow High. Molly Davis coming away with a steal. And Dow High will just hold on to the basketball as they come away with the victory here tonight. And well, Midland High scored the first basket of the game, but that was about the only thing that was positive for Midland here tonight, because from that point on, it was all Dow High. So many weapons, and with the injury to Skylar Howard, the size advantage, the three-pointers, the inside game, there's not much you can say except for the Dow High Chargers showed us what girls basketball is all about here in the state of Michigan, and they pull away with a victory tonight.
And this is what a number four team in the state looks like. You know, that Dow High has all the elements to go deep into the tournament, and Midland High, they really played hard tonight. They were just overmatched as far as inside game, but they played hard. Dow did everything they needed to not skip a beat.
Well, there's a lot of great teams out there in girls basketball, but I have a hunch that when the postseason comes around, whoever wins that Dow Heritage game might be booking their room in East Lansing.
Yes, I totally agree. We could have a semifinals or a final participant coming from our district.
Final stats in the girls game. Ellie Taylor, 25 points and 5 rebounds. Kaylee Wasco, 14 points, 6 rebounds, 3 blocks. Those were just two of the contributors for the Dow High Chargers, who played a great game here tonight at home. The boys are warming up on the court. You can check out the boys' coverage here on MPS-TV as well. For our great crew of John Walters, Dennis Caney, Jim Malik, Jeff Yoder, Tom Bell, my name is Jason Harper. Thank you for watching high school basketball here on MPS. The final score of the girls' game, Dow High 65, Midland High 31. Good night.